In this video, we'll have a brief look at how to draw Bezier curve in p5js. So I'm in Illustrator right now, and here's a straight line. So let me zoom in a little bit. The two points that make up this straight line is x one unit, which in this case is 10 pixel, x 10, and y 190. So that's the first point. And the second point is 90 for x and 10 for y. So if we know these two points location, then we can use a line function to draw this line. So that's all we need to know, right? But what about this curve on the right side? So it's got the same two points, x10, y190, and x90 and y10, but it looks different. And we can't just tell p5 to draw a curve by just giving it the coordinates of only two points. We need something more than that. We need where the control points are. So I'm going to hide the grid for a second and just highlight this curve. And I drew this curve with the pen tool in Illustrator. So the curves you draw with pen tool is called Bezier curve. There are two anchor points, the beginning point and end point, and two control points, each of which control an anchor point. You might say, wait a second, this anchor point has two control points, but this one isn't really part of this curve. I can show you that if I just move it around or make it longer, shorter, it doesn't have any effect on my curve. Whereas this one will do have some effect. And same here, this one really doesn't do anything. So if we had any preceding curve, this will belong to that preceding curve. And this point will belong to succeeding curve, if there's any. But this is just a simple curve segment. So only these two control points and two anchor points make up this curve. So how you set these two control points will determine how your curve will look like. As you can see in this case, they all have the same two anchor points, but the way I set these two control points are quite different. So I just told you that we need information about two control points to draw a Bezier curve, but that's not really the whole story. So I'm on this Bezier curve page from Wikipedia. If I scroll down a little bit, here's a section about constructing Bezier curves. So first one is a linear curve, which is basically a straight line that we already know how to draw. And then we go to quadratic curves. So in this case, this red curve, we only need this single control point in this case. So it all depends on, you know, mathematical description on how to construct this curve. And then higher order curves, if you look at this one does need two different control points. So that's what we are used to from, you know, something like Adobe Illustrator, like a pen tool. But also there are even higher order. So this one has three different control points as well. But for now, we'll just focus on this version of the Bezier curve with two control points. So I'm using p5js online editor, and we have Bezier function. So this function takes eight different parameters, four pairs of point coordinates. The first pair is first anchor points. I'll just call it p1. So p1x and p1y. And the second pair is first control point. So cp1x, cp1y. So if I use this curve as an example, that's p1x and that's p1y, p1x, p1y. And that's the control point one. So that'll be cp1x, cp1y. And then we go to cp2, second control point x and second control point y. So that'll be this one. So we're moving in this direction. First anchor point, first control point, and second control point, and the second anchor point. So I'm gonna end with p2x and p2y. So just like that, we need just eight different values. So let's recreate this curve here. So that's 100 by 200. So I'm gonna update my canvas size and Bezier function. So let's take this point, 10 and 190. And the first control point, which is x10, and y will be 70. And the second control point is x 90 and y will be 130. And then the last point will be x 90 and y 10. And if I run this, there you go. And I'm just going to set no fill. Okay, that wasn't too bad. And let's move on to something a little more complex, like this one, uppercase N. So I'm going to update my canvas, which here has a 200 by 400. I'm going to just comment this out and continue on here. So in this case, maybe I can do a straight line here, another straight line there, and maybe here's a Bezier curve. But then I will have to just rewrite the same point for the line and for the curve and be wasting my code a little bit, right? But we already know how to draw something more complex, shapes that have a lot of different points. We can use begin shape and end shape and use vertices inside, right? So I'm going to use that. So let's start with this one. So here we have x 20 and y 380. So I'm going to use vertex 20, 380. That's my first vertex. And then going this way, so this one will be x 20 and y 20. So vertex x 20 and y 20. And next one is a curve. But here, instead of using just Bezier, if the Bezier curve is a part of a more complex shape where it needs to be connected to, you know, other vertices or other curves, then we have another function called bezierVertex with the capital V. And this one doesn't take 8 different parameters because we have already defined the first anchor point, which is this vertex, 20, 20. So we don't need to rewrite that again. So we're just going to go directly to first control point, followed by second control point, and then the second anchor point. So we only need 6 different parameters for Bezier vertex function. So that's what I'm going to do. So the first control point looks like this is x20, and y will be 200. So 20, 200, and going to not the second anchor point, but the second control point. So that'll be x180. And y180 as well. And the second anchor point, this one, will be x180 and y380. So 180, 380. Looks like it works. And I will just add one more vertex to finish this shape right there. So that's pretty easy, just a simple vertex function with x180 and y20. And I'm gonna make this thicker. It looks like that's 2 units thick, which is 20 pixel. So before I begin my shape, I'm gonna set stroke weight to 20 pixels. Almost done. Looks like I have this stroke cap set to round, which is a default value. So I'm also going to change stroke cap to square. So I can just cut out at the end. Then maybe you can play with the stroke weight to make it a little thinner or thicker. Okay, looks good. So let's move on to the second shape. I'm gonna comment them all out. And let's start again. So again, start with begin shape and end shape. Then I'll be choosing either vertex or Bezier vertex. So I will start from here again, and maybe go this way. And there is this horizontal line, but I don't think this is part of my first shape here. So I'm just gonna maybe treat it as a simple line later after I finish this shape. So starting with this one, so x20 and y380. Vertex x20 and y380. And going all the way to the top, so that's 20, 20. The third one looks like this is still just simple vertex, right? So x will be 120 and y will be 20. And this segment here is a Bezier, so I'm going to use Bezier vertex. Again, starting with first control point, second control point, followed by the second anchor point. The first control point is this one, because we're moving in this direction. So we're going to start with this, move to this, and connect to this. So that's what, 160 for X and 20 for Y. And the second control point, X will be 130 and Y will be 140. And second anchor point will be X 180 and Y 140. Yeah, looks good. Let's continue on to the last point all the way at the bottom. So that's just simple vertex. X 180 and Y 380. So the first shape is done, and I'm going to move out of my end shape because this is not really part of this shape, and I'll just use simple line function in this case. So X is 20, Y will be 200. And the second point is X 180 and Y 200. Okay, so again, let's make this thicker stroke weight to 20. I'm almost done, but do you see any difference here? I see this corner looks a bit different, right? This is more round, and same with this corner that's round. But at the baseline, this is cut off and this is round. So let's fix this one first. So that's a stroke cap. I'm going to change to square. But this is not really a cap. It's not the end of a line, but this is where these points and lines meet. So we have another function called stroke join, which I will change to round. So that will solve our problem. Play with this stroke weight maybe. Let's go extreme. 60, I don't know, maybe 12. So that was a very brief introduction to how to draw a Bezier curve in P5, but there are a few other functions to draw a curve. So let's check out the reference section of the P5. I'm just going to scroll down. And here's a whole section on the curve. So we looked at Bezier, but there are a few different functions related to Bezier, but there is also another one called curve. So this one draws a curve, but it uses a different algorithm, which is called CADMOL ROM spline. So if you're interested in, you can find some more information online, like Wikipedia, or follow some simple examples from the reference. And curve also has a vertex version. So just like Bezier has Bezier vertex function, curve has a curve vertex. And here is a quadratic vertex that we looked at from Wikipedia, where it only has a single control point. So check those out. Maybe draw your own letter forms, shapes with curves inside. And I'll see you in the next video.